टेस्टिंग वन टू थ्री पीपल, वन टू थ्री. अरे वाई इज नो वन एबल टू हियर मी क्लियरली? वन सेकेंड गाइज, वन सेकेंड, लेट मी जस्ट चेक इफ एवरीथिंग इज ओके. और आई डोंट नो, आई कांट सी द चैट अपेरेंटली. गुड इवनिंग पीपल. गाइज होल्ड ऑन फॉर अ सेकेंड, लेट मी जस्ट रीस्टार्ट माई दिस थिंग. All right. Can you guys all hear me? Yes. What's up? How are you guys doing? Hello, people. Good evening, Lucky. Hi, Aruna. What's up? Hi, good evening, Devasis. Hi, Shizuka. What's up, sir? Everything. It's okay. Yeah, good to know, Shashi. What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? How was life, people? How was life? How was quarantine life treating you, people? Hi, Bhargavi. How are you doing? Hi, Shizuka. What's up? All good? Everything great? Yeah, how many of you guys got scolded today from your parents? Nobody. Hey, don't lie, da, don't lie. If I can still get scolded, then you should also. This is not fair. This is not fair. Today's people are getting, you know, today's children are all getting spoiled. Yeah, today we'll be having Menti also. Don't worry, people. Good girl, it's... all right. Anyways, yeah. All right. I'll believe. What choice do I have? I have to believe. Anyways, welcome to today's session, people. I hope that all of you guys are doing good. My name is Anup, and this here is with Anthu 9th and 10th English channel. Once again, hoping that all of you guys are doing good and taking care of yourself. Welcome. Oh, is it? Oh, that's so dab and all. She's so happy that her parents are out of town. Who's cooking and all? Huh? Math ex. Who's math expert? Me. All right. Yes, I'm math, social science, economics. What else is there? Socio, political. All experts. Obviously, I get scolded for everything. Now. It's not like one thing in particular. So, okay, I'm used to it. Anyways, welcome to today's session, guys. So this is going to be session number 7 of Refraction Through a Lens. And today's topic is going to be about power of a lens and its application. It's a very important topic and it's a very easy topic as well. It's not hard at all. All you have to do is this. Listen carefully when I'm teaching. And yes, we will have the mentee. Please don't start a movement in the chat box. Don't worry, for sure, after the topic is complete, we will be having the mentee as well. You can always, you know, you can just go to the website and keep it ready, www.menti.com, keep it ready. And when the quiz starts, log into that. I'll tell you the code and then we'll get started. Sounds good, people. Can I get a quick yes in the chat box? So one important thing you have to think that my number asks you to refresh his mentee time while others don't have such problem. He copies the link. Oh, is that true? Is that, I don't think that is possible, is it? So my parents are, they're also, all right, Shizuka. All right. Anyways, so with that said, people, let's get started. And this topic, like I told you, is going to be a very important topic. Understanding about the power of a lens and where all do we use this is going to be a super duper important topic. So with that said, without wasting any more time, let's get started. But as always, without Superman lifting up a log of wood, how can we start a day? So yes, let's do this. So the quote for today says, guys, if you cannot do great things, do small things in a great way. And this was said by Napoleon Hill. This is so very true, guys. This is so very true. Not all of us are, you know, born into greatness, or not all, you know, have the opportunity to, you know, to just get into something, doing something great. We're not all, you know, it's not possible. But what you can do is do everything that you do, even, you know, folding your bed sheet or keeping your bed clean. Even that, if you're able to do it in a great way, even the smallest task, that is what is going to lead you to greatness one day. And trust me, people, it's not just to make your bed clean. No, I'm not saying this. It is a fact. If you start doing small things great, eventually you'll start doing even the big things great. Because if you can't get the small things right, you cannot get the big things right. So that's the lesson for today. I hope you guys take it in your heart and sink it in and start doing everything that you do, even the smallest thing, whatever it is, even a small task of you going getting something from the shop. If you can do it in the best way possible, that is what greatness is all about. All right. So that's it, guys. Enough of my bashan. So people, in today's session, this is going to be session number 7. That means we have completed today's topic. And tomorrow we will have another mentee quiz of the entire chapter. So tomorrow also I'm be coming live for ICSE 10th, and we'll be doing the entire chapter quiz. So how many of you guys would be there for tomorrow's session? I think it'll be exactly the same time, 4:45. tomorrow we'll be coming live again, guys. And this time the entire session would be covered, the whole chapter quiz of Menti. So we'll have only Menti and nothing else. But yes, come prepared. Don't just walk in like waltz in like this is the end of the world. Don't do that, people. Prepare for your sessions and then come to the next one. All right. Hi, Da. Yes, there will be Da for sure. I haven't gotten a chance to, you know, reply to your email. I'm definitely doing it now. It's okay. Chill. I know. Don't worry, guys. Don't worry. Today, I'm not going to refresh anything. Relax. So, people, with that said, let's get started. So, in the last session, refraction through lenses, I actually asked you a homework, a very simple question. The question was this. If the magnification of a lens is 0.5 plus 0.5, state how are you and we related. So, if you guys remember the formula in the regular sessions, I told you that M is equal to, that is magnification is equal to V by U, where V is nothing but the distance of the image and U is nothing but the distance of the object. So, if magnification is 1 by 2, then what would be the relationship between V and U? It will be V is 2V is equal to U. That is, you know, cross multiplication. U goes to the other side. V goes to the other. 2 goes to the other side. So get us U is equal to 2V or V is equal to 2V is equal to U. That's all. This is the relationship between magnification, image distance, and object distance if the magnification is given as 0.5, which is nothing but 1 by 2. Sounds good, people? All good? Yes, people, all good. Everyone understood this easy question? Bacha question, laddu question. Chill. It's okay. Let it go, guys. It's all right. We will be doing the quiz today also. No, relax. All right. Sounds good. Okay, people. Then we'll get started, guys. Here is your power of a lens. Now, first question I want to know is, how many of you guys here use a specs like me? Like this beautiful specs that you see over here. How many of you guys have this problems? Now you will study. Exactly. Yeah. Shezirkaji. Rahul, why? At least to make it look cool, you know, wear those Cariminati wala specs. Looks cool. Everyone. Okay, pretty much everyone. Because all of us use a lot of mobile phones and laptops and all. So it's understandable. Now, if you've ever used a specs before, or if you've ever asked your friend before, they would have already told you that the power of my lens is, the power of my specs is 0.5. Minus 0.5. 1, 2. Have you ever heard that before? Give me a quick yes. Have you ever heard that before? Like the power of my lens is so and so. My power of my lens is minus so and so or plus so and so. You've probably heard this, no? Myopia, hypermetropia. You already know this, right? Now, what exactly is this power? Let's understand this. First of all, guys, we know in the last session we have seen what is focal length. Focal length is what? Or focus is what? It's basically a point on the principal axis, that is after refraction, the rays of light come and meet. That is nothing but a point on the principal axis where the rays of light after refraction comes and meet. That is called as a focal point. And the distance from the optic center to that focal point is called as a focal length. We already know all of this. Now, what we did not see was that if you change the focal length of a lens, the amount of light that gets bent through that lens, passing through that lens, would also change. Once again, if you change the focal length of the lens, the amount of light that bends through the, or the amount of light, the capability of the lens to bend the ray of light would also differ. But by how much? By what? Let's understand this. See, guys, if you increase the focal length, the amount of light that is bent by that the lens decreases. Once again, if you increase the focal length, the amount of light that is bent, that gets bent by that lens decreases. On the other hand, if you decrease the focal length, the amount of light that gets bent by the lens increases. Did you understand this? This is the first most important thing that you will understand when it comes to power. Again, if you increase the focal length, the amount of light that gets bent, that is passing through the lens, decreases. But if you decrease the focal length, the amount of light that gets bent through the lens increases. Sounds good? Exactly, guys. Exactly. Now, the amount of light that gets bent through, by what degree is it, or by how much does it? That is what power tells us. Once again, what is power? Power is nothing but a factor that tells you by how much is the lens able to bend the ray of light. That's all. What is power? Once again, it is nothing but a factor or property of a lens, but which tells us by how much does that ray of light get bent when it's passing through that lens. That's all. That is what power tells us. Now, here's the thing, guys. The formula of power is one of the most simplest things to remember. P is equal to 1 by F, which is nothing but the reciprocal of the focal length. So, what does this mean? If you increase the focal length, the power of the lens decreases. On the other hand, if you decrease the focal length, the power of the lens would increase. That's all. If you increase the focal length, the power of the lens would decrease. If you decrease the focal length, then the power of the lens would increase. That's all. Exactly, people. P is equal to 1 by F, where P is nothing but the power of the lens, which is represented by capital P, and F is nothing but the focal length. And the focal length is generally represented in meters, and the SI unit of power is something called as diopter. It's called as diopter, which is represented by the letter D. It's called as diopter represented by the letter D. Now, you use the unit diopter when and only when the focal length is given in meters. If it is given in centimeters or something else, then you have to convert it to meters first before you put the the diopter as the SI unit of power. So you always have to take good care when it comes to the units, people. So here also, make sure that the focal length is converted to meter before you find out the power, because diopter is a SI unit only when the focal length of that lens is given in terms of meter. Sounds good, people. All of you guys understood this so far? Give me a quick yes, people. We'll have the mentira. Chill. Let's study first. Then we'll do the mentira. Got it? Yes, people. Everyone, I want a quick yes, people. All of you guys. What is happening now? So, power numericals are in syllabus. They might ask you as a part of a bigger numerical, they might ask you to find out the image distance or the object distance, and then they might ask you to find out the power. Just remember this one formula, that's all. P is equal to 1 by F. If you find the focal length of that lens, you can easily find out the power of the lens. Now, if you want to remember the formula of focal length, remember it's 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F for a lens. So once you find out the focal length, put it in this equation to find out the formula of power as well. That's all. To find out the value of power. Got it? Yes, people, will have mentira. Don't worry, people. Yes, all good. Yes, people. That's it. Let's get into it. Let's understand what type of powers do we have. See, guys, generally we have negative and positive. That's all. Positive, negative. Negative, positive. That's all. Now, when do we have positive? When do we have negative? When the focal length is positive, you have positive power. When the focal length is negative, negative power. Why? Because P is equal to 1 by F. So if this is negative, this will also be negative. If this is positive, this will also be positive. Simple. That's all. Now, in the chat box, when do we have positive focal length, people? In the chat box? Exactly, Arunaji. Exactly. We get positive focal length if the lens is a convex lens. Because in a convex lens, the focal length or the focal point lies behind the mirror and hence, or behind the lens, sorry, and hence it'll have positive value. On the other hand, if you talk about negative focal length, it's going to be for a concave lens. Simple. Once again, positive power is when the focal length is positive. And which lens has a positive focal length? It's a convex lens. And on the other hand, negative is when you have negative focal length. And a negative focal length is when you have a convex lens. That's a concave lens. Got it? That's all, guys. That's all. So if you have understood the first couple of topics, this chapter or this topic is going to be super duper duper laddu, people. It's going to be a super interesting, super easy topic to remember. Once again, positive for positive focal length. And when do we have a positive focal length? Remember the sign convention, guys. This is positive, this is negative, this above is positive and below is negative. And when the focal length is behind the lens, that is when you have positive focal length, and that is for a convex lens. For a concave lens, on the other hand, the focal length lies on the same side of the object, and hence the focal length is negative. That's all. All right. Now, talking about one very important thing. See, guys, if you talk about a low powered lens, that means that its focal length is longer. It has a longer focal length. Remember, P is equal to 1 by F. So if this is more, or this is less, sorry, this is going to be more. So if the power of the lens is less, that means it has a longer focal length, and that means the amount of ray of light that it bends is going to be a little lesser compared to a high powered lens. On the other hand, if you talk about a high powered lens, that means the focal length is very short, and more importantly, it can bend more amount of light, or can bend at a much more higher degree. That's all. It'll bend the light more. The rays of light will be bent more in a high powered lens, and a low powered lens, the amount of bending of ray of light would be much more lesser, and it'll have a longer focal length. Now, again, people, you don't have to remember by heart all of these. Just remember this one thing. Everything gets a lot easier. That's all. Just remember that one thing. Everything. You can explain everything just if you remember that. So if the power of the lens is less, the focal length is going to be more, and that means the bending of ray of light is going to be less. If it's a high powered lens, the focal length is going to be shorter. More importantly, there will be more bending of ray of light. Now, if you look at the size of the lens, do you guys find some difference, people, in the first one and the second one? Anyone who's able to spot the difference between the first one and the second one? Yeah, I don't know. You can. Anyone else is able to differentiate between the first one and the second one? Anyone? Anyone? Nothing? No difference? All same? Or both of these are convex? Convex lenses, right? That's all? No, people. If you look at the lens, what do you have to do with that? Think about this, guys. If the lens is a thin lens, then the power of that lens is going to be less. Power of the lens is going to be less. Have you ever seen people who have thick lenses? Have you ever seen their specs looks a little weird? Because that means that the lens has more power. That means there's more bending of ray of light happening over there. Whereas a person like me, my power is minus 0.5, I guess. It's not minus. That means I have a concave lens in my specs. And more importantly, it's very small. The power is very small. Minus 0.5 is very negligible. So that way you can understand if the lens is going to be a thin lens or a thick lens. So if you want more bending of ray of light, if you want a shorter focal length, then you have to use a thick lens. So a thick lens has more power, whereas a thin lens, on the other hand, has less power. Another way to look at it is thin lens means the refraction that happens would be actually, the amount of refraction that happens is going to be a little lesser. A thick lens means the amount of refraction that happens is going to be more. That's all. Yes, people, is it clear? So please explain why these concepts are learned. It's because they're learned too. It's like, you know, it's asking this question, what is this? Why is the earth round? Because it's round, that's all. So is the speed of light different in different mediums? 100% Rahul, that's why we have refraction now. That's why we have refraction. Sir, can you please remove that? No, Abhishek. No. If I remove my specs, I look like I'm sleeping. No need. Guys, is it all clear? Is it all clear, people? Nimjam, okay. Guys, is it all clear? Everyone. Is everything clear? Done? No, that's all, people. Now, to talk about the application of lenses. Where all do we use it? Now, one of the most common examples is your specs. You already know that. That is one of the most common examples. But there are a lot of other places also where we use lenses. Your camera lens. What do you think these things are? All these things are what? These are all basically lenses. They are all lenses itself. Inside of it, they have lenses. Telescope, cameras, slide projectors, they all have lenses inside of them. And majority of them, all of these generally use convex lens because they want the rays of light to come and converge at a point. So because convex lenses are converging lenses, so you want them to converge and meet at a particular point and form a real inverted image, which by processing and all that can be again inverted back, and you can see it in the form of an image. So in all of these, your slide projectors, in the case of your telescopes, in the case of your mobile phones, all of those lenses use convex lens, and yes, they all have lenses inside of them. Secondly, if you talk about your eye lens, our body itself has a convex lens. The eye lens that is there, it itself is a convex lens which can change the focal length whenever it wants. So if you want to see something far away, your eyes would change the focal length accordingly. If you want to see the nearby object, it'll change the focal length accordingly. So it'll become thin or thick depending on where the object is and by how far you want to see the object. So depending on all of that, we basically change the, you know, the size of the lens, or in other words, the focal length of the lens, so that we can see the object clearly. But sometimes, guys, sometimes there'll be some sort of defect in your eyes, which can be called as myopia, which is nothing but nearsightedness. So myopia is called as nearsightedness. That means that a person can see what is nearby. Nearsightedness is what is it? Is sightedness? Yeah, you get the spelling, no? So when a person has myopia, that means he can see what's nearby, but he cannot see what's far away. All the far away objects look blurry. You would have had some friends in your school, in your class, who cannot see if they're sitting in the back of the class. So they have to come to the front and sit, and you think that they are all geeks and you make fun of them. Yeah. How many of you guys know such people? Or if you are one such people, can you give me a quick yes in the chat box? Are you one such? Yeah. So yeah, those are people with myopic eyes or nearsightedness. So yes, that means that the person can see what's nearby, can't see what's far away. So for them to correct that myopic eye, you have to use a concave lens, because in a myopic eye, the eye image is formed in front of the retina. So you want the image to be formed on the retina, and so you increase the focal length by using a concave lens. On the other hand, some people can see what's far away clearly but can't see what's nearby. This is called as hypermetropia. This is also called as farsightedness. It's called as farsightedness. That means a person can see what's far away but can't see what's nearby. To correct this, we use a convex lens. To correct this, because here what happens is the image is formed behind the retina. In myopia, the image is formed in front of the retina. This is called as the retina, basically. This region is called as the retina. In a myopia, the image is formed in front of the retina. You see this? This is the retina. The image is formed here. You want the image to be formed on the retina, and hence you use a concave lens. In the case of hypermetropia, we use a convex lens to correct it so that the image can be formed on the retina, because the image is formed behind the retina in the case of hypermetropia. Is it clear, people? All good? I know this is removed from the topic. Now, this is just for extra information. These are all the applications. Even though it's removed from your syllabus, you're not safe yet. You have to do all of these, because they might ask you as one mark question. Probably they might ask you as one mark question. Although this is not for CBSE, I'm telling it again, for CBSE, Colorful World has been removed. Majority of the topics from Colorful World has been removed. But this is ICSE for, refraction through a lens. For them, these are all important. Alright, remember this. Alright, apart from that, magnifying glasses. In this also, we use a convex lens because we want the image to be magnified. So we use a convex lens over here. In the case of a collimator of a spectrometer. So what is a collimator of a spectrometer? Let me tell you this, guys. It's a small thing. It's a spectrometer is a device that is used to study about light. Because majority of you guys already know that light is an electromagnetic wave. That means that it is not just the visible light. You have X-rays, you have UV rays, infrared rays. There are all of these are a part of light. To study that, we use a device called a spectrometer. And in spectrometer, you need a source of light. So when the light is coming out from an object, it is sent out in different direction, right? It'll be sent in so many different directions. But in a spectrometer, you want all the rays of light to be parallel to each other. To ensure that, we use something called as a collimator, which basically is nothing but a convex lens itself. So we use this to make sure that all the lights are parallel to each other so that we can study about the electromagnetic spectrum of light. God, people, this is one of the applications. It's a complicated one. You'll be studying more about this in your 12th grade as well. So don't worry about it when you study about diffraction and all that. You'll be studying a little bit about this as well. For now, just understand this, guys. We use a convex lens in something called as a collimator of a spectrometer. Again, spectrometer is a device that is used to study the electromagnetic spectrum of light. And in that, to make all the rays of light parallel to each other, we use something called as a collimator. That's all, right? Apart from this, we also have Galilean telescope. In this also, we use both concave as well as convex lenses. It's a combination of both concave and convex lenses. So the eyepiece generally is concave, and the lens that gathers the light from the object, from distance object, that is, you know, your celestial objects and all, that is basically a convex lens. So you use a combination of both these lenses in a Galilean telescope. You'll be studying a little bit more about this also later when you talk about different types of telescopes in your higher grades. You'll be studying that as well. So for this also, we use a combination of both the lenses. Apart from that, in chromatic aberrations as well, we use lenses. Now, how many of you guys know photography over here? Anyone who's interested in photography or have, you know, have this, you know, I have this idea of photography and all that? Because I, for sure, am not a photographer, but yeah. Shivam, you know that? All right. Now, how many of you have seen this kind of filters before? Like in, I think in Instagrams and all that, you've probably seen this kind of filter before where you have different colors. Yeah, you've probably seen this, no? This is called as chromatic aberration. What is chromatic aberration? So you see this, you can see different colors. You can see blue color, you can see green color, you can see red color, yellow color, you can see different colors. So sometimes what happens is that when there is a, when the lens is faulty, what happens is that different wavelength of light, because all colors have different wavelengths. You remember that, no? Red light has a different wavelength compared to blue. Blue has a different wavelength compared to yellow, and yellow has different wavelength compared to green. So every color has a different wavelength. So in chromatic aberration, what happens is that different wavelength of light will diffract in different ways. You see this? They are all diffracting and meeting at different points. So this is how you're getting that different colors. So to combine all of these and make sure that you're getting a proper clear image, we have to use a lens. For that, generally, again, we use either a concave lens or a convex lens, or a combination of both concave and convex lenses to merge all those rays of light and bring it to one point so that we can get a clear image. So this is also another application of your power of a lens, or in other words, lenses. Got it, guys? Is it all clear, people? Yes, people. In all of these, we'll be using all of that. So guys, is everything clear? Hi, Kitto, what's up? Is everyone clear with everything, people? Give me a quick yes in the chat box if you understood everything so far. All good, guys? All good? Yes? Is there any doubts that you would like to ask me? So application of lenses is the easiest and the laduest thing. All right, sir. All right. So in the torches, where will be the search and headlight be fixed? See, now in torches, we basically use mirrors. We don't use lenses per se. The middle of the lens, you can use basically the middle part of it. No, like, how do I show it? Like if you have a torch, no, in the middle, it looks a little different. Over there, we use basically a concave lens to spread the light out as much as we can. But we also use a concave mirror in the back to spread out the light. So there's reflection of light happening from behind and the spreading of light happening from the front as well. All right. So it's a combination of both mirrors and lenses, not just lenses. All right. So do telescopes have thin lenses and microscopes have thick lenses? Depends. If you talk about the big ones, obviously the lenses would be thicker. It'll not be thin because you want to focus all that ray of light onto one point. So you cannot have only thin lenses. And microscopes also, depending on them, like if you have different types of microscopes as well. You have these, electron microscopes. You have different kinds of normal microscopes as well. So depending on the power of the microscope, it's not like you can use one particular microscope to do everything. You have different degrees in that as well. So depending on that, the kind of lens would be used in that would also be different, because that is why they have different powers. All right, it all depends on that. Says, will Galilean telescope diagram come in? No, Siddharth, no, it'll not be asked in exam. Don't worry, da. So do telescopes, like I told you, Anna, it depends on the kind of the telescopes you have. Some of them, the common telescopes that you have, the one that you can buy in Amazon and all that, that would probably have a thinner telescope, thinner lens comparatively. But if you talk about big telescope, like, you know, your the Webb telescope that is going on, that is currently being built, or if you talk about the Hubble Space Telescope, in all of that, you'll have bigger lenses. Obviously, you can't use a thin lens over there. Over there, it'll be thicker. All right. So why aperture is bigger in telescope? Because you want to collect as many amount of light possible. Now, that's why. Because more the aperture, more amount of light will incident on it. So the better the image would be. That's why. All right. So electron microscope can do everything. Yeah, obviously. It's more powerful. Obviously. It will be there. Insane. It's for, again, this is for ICSE, and for ICSE, it is a part of it. So can we burn a piece of paper by focusing a ray? Definitely you can do that. You use a convex lens for that. You use a convex lens. You can use a simple magnifying lens for that. Okay? Because if you keep the lens at a particular distance, all that ray of light would basically fall on the focus because it's a convex lens. So the rays of light would meet at a particular point. So if you keep it exactly at that distance, exactly at the focal length, if you keep the image or the object, that is your paper, or if you talk about a dried leaf and all that, it'll start to burn. I've actually done this. Yeah. Luckily, I did not burn myself. So convex is your answer to your question. All right, is it clear, guys? Love you guys to know. All right, people. So chalte hai menti. Okay. Yeah. We'll do the menti. Check. So remember, let's get into menti. But before we get into menti, 2 minutes of your time, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. I would request 2 minutes of your time, and after that, we will be doing the menti. Just give me 2 minutes of your time. I have an important thing to say to all the newcomers out there. So majority of you guys already know about it, but yes, for the newcomers, ladies and gentlemen, listen to me for the next 2 minutes. Now here's the thing, guys. Serious talk. So we had asked you a poll asking you people what are your problems that you guys are facing these days when it comes to studying, because a lot has changed ever since the quarantine and things have become a little difficult for you to cope up with, because majority of you guys are not used to this online platforms. Majority of you guys are used to going to your school and studying. So there are a lot of problems that you guys are facing these days. So these are things that you guys had told us when we had asked a poll asking you people what are the problems that you guys are facing. One thing is doubts, right? Because majority of your doubts are not getting cleared on time. There are a lot of websites out there, but then it takes about 24 hours to 48 hours to get your doubts cleared. So that's a long time to wait for getting your simple doubts cleared. Notes, because you're not able to download the notes that the teacher has written. Most times than not, you're not able to download the notes, so you can't refer to what you were taught in that particular class. Thirdly, tests and assignments, because obviously you don't want to go and write your exams just like that without any sort of practice. So you want to practice before you get into your exam halls, and how do you get those tests and assignments, and who's going to check that? That's another problem, right? Fourthly, competitive exams, right? Because your NTSCs are lurking around the corner. You have a lot of other exams also that you want to give. So how do you prepare yourself for your competitive exams? Fifth, choice of your own schedule, because yes, that's also a big problem right now, because some of you guys might not feel like studying at 5 o'clock in the evening. Some of you guys might feel like studying at 9 o'clock. So, but it's not possible for you to, for you to ask the teacher to come and teach at 9 o'clock, because sessions happen according to the discretion of the teacher as well as the organization. So choosing your own schedule has become a very big conflict of interest. Fifth, but definitely not the least, is definitely choice of your own language. Because not everyone understands English, not everyone understands Hindi. India is a country with so many diversified language. So to understand all of these in your own language, it's going to be a big uphill task. Now, these are all the problems. I'm pretty sure that there are a lot more to this, and you would be able to relate to at least few of these problems out of what I've stated. But what is the solution, right? Don't worry, guys. Vedantu's here. Vedantu has solved all of your problems. Inside the class, you will not just have one teacher. You will have the master teacher to help you clear your conceptual doubts and help you understand the concept. But together with that, you will also have someone called as a class teacher. Now, the class teacher's function is to make sure that your doubts are cleared inside the class. So whatever doubts you come up with, the class teacher would be there on the other hand to clear your doubts right there and then. So you don't walk out of the class with more doubts. You instead walk out of the class with a clear set of ideas what you've been taught in the class. You can download all the notes and watch each and every recording. So if in case you miss out a session, or if you want to write down or note down something that the teacher has written, you can always download whatever the teacher has written and refer to it as many number of times you want. Everything can be downloaded in the form of PDF, and you can watch the recordings as well. Apart from that, you have regular tests and assignments, monthly tests and assignments, chapter wise tests and assignments to check where you're going wrong. And based on these tests and assignments that you take, you'll also be given a detailed report card as well, which tells you where you're going wrong, what things you have to improve on, and what are the topics that you're good at. Every detail would be put up in that performance report card, which you'll be getting at the end of every month. And you'll also be trained for your competitive exams, which I'll be telling in a minute. So you have NTSCs, ISOs, Olympiads, whatever exams that you guys are planning to write, you'll be trained for that as well. And you can choose your own schedule. Whatever time you feel like studying, you can choose that time. You don't have to come to the teacher's will or the organization's will. Whenever you feel like studying, you can open up the app or the website and study at that point of time. And you can choose your own language. Classes are offered in both English as well as in Hindi. I'm pretty sure that majority of you guys can understand Hindi or English. So the classes are offered in that. If you're someone who's comfortable in English, you can choose that. If you're someone who's comfortable in Hindi, then you can choose that medium of language to be the, you know, major source of communication transfer that happens. All right, now, apart from all of these, you'll also have unlimited live classes, all micro courses and crash courses for free, performance report card like I told you before, and personalized attention. What you do is click on the link that is given in the description below. It'll also be put up in the comment section as well. All you need to do is click on that and they will take you to a website which basically looks like this. And the thing is this, people, until 15th of November, initially it was 11th of November, but the date has been extended to 15th of November. Until the 15th of November, you would have all courses at a discount of exactly 50%. No questions asked. There's no hidden taxes or charges, asterisk mark with whatever, no hidden charges. All the courses would be at a 50% off discount. So what you're going to do is click on the link. Once you click on the link, they'll ask you which grade you belong to. 1 to 12th is the option that you have. Let's say you're in 10th grade or 9th grade. Once you click on it, they'll ask you which board you belong to, CBC or CBSE Maharashtra. Click on the board that you belong to, this particular board. Once you click on it, this is what you're going to get. Everything that I just told you in one glance. What you're going to do is click on get subscription. Once you click on get subscription, this is what you're going to get. 1 month, 3 months, 6 months. Now again, I'm going to tell you guys, this is only valid till 15th of November, and all the courses have been dropped down by 50%. Now, what do I mean by 50% discount? Let me just tell you this, guys. For a 1 month program, the base price is 4,000 rupees, which is a lot of money. I totally understand it, but you get a primary discount on that, and the price comes down to 2,699. On top of that, if you want to save more money, enter the coupon code AME Pro, get additional 50% discount on 2,699, where the price comes down to 1,349 rupees. So you get a discount of 1,349 rupees for the next month, and what you'll be paying is 1,349 rupees for the whole month. Let's say we're going to go to the 3 month program. For the 3 month program, the base price is 10,000 rupees, which again is a lot of money. I understand that. The base price comes down to 6,999. On top of that, if you enter the coupon code AME Pro, you get additional 50% discount on the 6,999, where the discount comes down to 3,499, and what you'll be paying is 3,499.5 paise for the next 3 months, which is basically like 1,100 rupees or something per month. That's all for all the subjects. With everything that I just told you, just that. Apart from that, if you want to go for the 6 month program, the base price is 16,000 rupees. Again, you get a primary discount on that. It comes down to 11,499. On top of that, if you enter the coupon code AME Pro, you get additional 50% discount on that 11,499. So you get a whopping discount of 5,749. Again, guys, this is valid only till 15th of November. That's all the validity is. And the base price that you'll be paying is 5,749, which is less than 1,000 rupees for a month. For the next 6 months, all the best courses and the best online platform, I would say, hands down, with, you know, quizzes every single session, everything that you would like, all you have to do is just click on the link in the description and enter the coupon code AME Pro. That's all. All right, guys. So that's it. Let's get into it now. All right, people, that's it. The all awaited quiz. Let's get into Mentimeter for now. So people, the code for today is 6884845. Quickly join the Mentimeter and we will get started with today's quiz. Come on. I'm thirsty. Good evening, people. Good evening. What's up? Welcome. The code is listed up. 6884845. Let's go. Yeah. Good evening, people. Good evening. Welcome, Sean. What's up, buddy? How are you doing? Long time. It'll be for 15. Sure. For to 10 minutes. Not 10 minutes, 15th. Thank you, Siddhant. Thanks a lot, guys. Come on, guys. Happy Diwali in advance. I completely forgot that it's Diwali. I have sessions on that day as well. So, yeah. Happy Diwali to you guys, at least. And don't burst crackers, people. Please don't burst any crackers. Try to, keep the environment a little clean. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Can you refresh the page? No more refreshing the page. They're thinking that I'm helping you guys cheat. So, no more refreshing. Sorry. You can join the Mentimeter. www.menti.com and enter the code 6884845. And I don't know why I'm sweating so much. Hold on, guys. Rajinikanth style. Alright, done people. 60 of you guys are already here. Everyone who hasn't joined the Mentimeter yet, quickly join the Mentimeter, guys. It's www.menti.com and the code for today is 68848451. Once you enter the code, you can take a part of the quiz as well. Don't just sit there simply now. What are you gonna sit there and do? Huh? Count stars, huh? Do it quickly. Exactly. Hashtag no refreshing. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So will you be there in Diwali celebration with Master Agents? Yeah, Durga, I'll be there to spoil your Diwali. Don't worry. I'm there. Alright guys, I'm gonna start the quiz in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The first question for the team. Let's go. Here it is. It's gonna be simple, guys. Don't worry. Consider two lenses. First with power 4D, which is 4 diopter, and second with power 5D. Which lens can bend the ray of light more? 4D, 5D, both would bend the ray of light equally or can't say? Very simple. Consider two lenses. First with power 4D, the other with power 5D. Which lens can bend the ray of light more? 4D, 5D, both can equally bend the ray of light or can't say? You have 6 seconds. 66 of you guys have already answered. Now, all those who haven't answered yet, guys, quickly join the Mentimeter, www.menti.com, and enter the code 68848485. That's all for today. That is the code for today. Well done, people. Good start. 46 of you guys were able to give the right answer. Exactly correct, people. Remember this. More is the power of the lens, more it can bend the ray of light. And that means the lens is going to be a little thicker. So 5D lens is going to be a little thicker compared to a 4D lens, which means that it can bend the ray of light even more further than that. And that means 5D would have smaller focal length as well. So remember this, guys. More is the power of the lens, more can it bend the ray of light, which means that it has lesser focal length as well. So that is the answer. Very good start, people. Here is your leaderboard for the first question. I am not going to take out the first name. Followed by, it's something that you do in the morning, followed by Rabbit, then it's Ananya, Karthik, Nijam, Hi Fi to you, Dada, Abhishek, sir, what's Hi Fi? Okay, Abhishek, what's Hi Fi? Hi Fi to you too. Darth Vader, Vignan, you do the Hi Fi, Princey, and Pingu. All right. Congratulations, Pingu. Congratulations. Who's the first one now? Who's P, hashtag P? Who's that? Can anyone tell me who's that? Who's come out, whoever you are. All right, second question. Take a look at this one. Serious time. On reducing the focal length of the lens, its power decreases, increases, does not change, first increases and then decreases. On reducing the focal length of the lens, what happens to the power? Decreases, increases, does not change, first increases, then decreases. 16 seconds, 60. Everyone has voted. Array, amazing people. 59. That is an amazing number, people. Almost 60%, no, almost 90% of the class. Beautifully done, guys. Exactly correct, because we know that P is equal to 1 by F, which means if that decreases, if focal length decreases, power of the lens increases. Well done, guys. Here is your leaderboard at the end of that question. P hashtag P is still on top, followed by Pranav, followed by Aranya, then it's Karthik, Nijam, Darth Vader, Vignan. No, it's changed a lot. Aranya in the second, third is Pranav, fourth is Darth Vader, fifth is Vignan, sixth is Karthik, then it's Princey, Nijam, Pingu, and Abhishek as well. Congratulations, guys. Well done. Good stuff. Moving on to the third question. Good stuff so far. Let's see if you can repeat the same history once again. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All those who haven't joined the Menti yet, the code is 68848485. Quickly join in. Here is your next question. Take a look at this one. Consider two lenses. First with power 6D and the second with power 7D. Which lens has more focal length? Which of this has more focal length? 6D or the 71? 6D, 7D, both have the same focal length or can't say at all. 20 seconds. Let's go, guys. Come on. So power of the lens is removed from syllabus. Kittu, for CBSE, yes, no, for not for ICSE, I believe. For ICSE, it's still a part of the syllabus, no? Because this is for ICSE. This is mainly for ICSE. But yes, even CBSE's people can attend it. There's no problem in that. Anything else, guys? Anything else? No? I know, right? Everything is light, dude. 8, exactly, guys. 48 of you guys gave the right answer. 8 is going to be 6D, guys. Which has more focal length? P is equal to 1 by F. If the power is more, focal length is going to be less. If the power is less, the focal length is going to be more. 6D has more power. That means focal length is going to be less. Why? P is equal to 1 by F. If you just remember that one formula, guys, you can solve every question related to power. P is equal to 1 by F. Never forget this. Write it in your heart. Don't literally write it and go to your exams. No. Write in your heart in the sense, like, imaginary. Do it. Don't literally write it and then just do that. That's not fair. All right. Here's your leaderboard, people. At the end of that question, it is... Iron Man and all is here. Where is the rest of the Avenger group? Pranav, poop. It came out by mistake. P hashtag hashtag P followed by Pranav. That is Nijam, Prince, Darth Vader, Abhishek, Kavyansh, Manya. Love you, Pranadandan, sir. All right. And like Iron Man as well. Congratulations. Congratulations. It's so hard to remember, read your names and all that. Okay, here is your last question for today, guys. That's all. We are done. The last question. Go for it. Enjoy this. Sink it in. Which lens has more power? Options are thick lens, a thin lens, both have the same power, or can't say. Very simple question. Go for it. Let's go. CBSE, we have power of lenses. You guys have power of lenses? Okay. Oh yes, you have. That is actually a part of light. It is part of light, no? It is not a part of colorful world, no. You don't have myopia, hypermetropia, presbyopia and all that, but you do have power of lenses. Yes, my bad, people. Sorry about that. Got a little confused. Sorry. Laddu, no? Exactly. Everything is Laddu only. Everything is Laddu. All right, anyways. Laddu, no? This is Laddu, right? Congratulations, sir. 28 of you guys got the wrong answer. 36 of you guys, by a slight majority, exactly the case. It's going to be a thick lens, people. If the power of the lens is more, it's going to be a thick lens. That means it can bend the ray of light more. And so the focal length will be less. A thin lens, however, has less power. The focal length would be more on that. Imagine this, Dev. So, like, this is how I remembered when I was in 10th. This is how I remembered. A thick lens means the ray of light has to go through a lot more material. That means it will bend even more further. Just remember it like that. It will bend even more further. A thin lens, on the other hand, is comparatively thinner. So the light ray does not have to go through so much material. So the amount of refraction happening is going to be a little lesser. So the power of the lens is less and the focal length will be more for that. That's all. This is how you remember it. This is how, you know, I know it's not exactly scientific, but still, it is scientific. But yes, if you want to remember it like that, you could actually remember it like that. All right. So anyways, I will have to say out this name finally. Nonetheless, here is your final leaderboard. P hashtag, hashtag P is the winner for today. Congratulations, congratulations, congratulations with 3,979 points. Followed by Darth Vader in the second. Somehow he's not able to defeat Luke Skywalker. Followed by Abhishek in the third. Fourth is Preda. Fifth is Iron Man. Sixth is Hardik, Leo, Messi fan. Sixth is Kittu. Seventh is Love You, Cutie Pie Sai. Thank you, Da. Then we have Kavashish the Great, good to know. Then it's Pranadanadan, sir. I'm sorry if I'm getting it wrong now, but congratulations, people. That is all from my side. That is all the quest for today, people. If you have any doubts, this is the time for you to put it down. And also, guys, one more important thing is this, guys. You have a homework for today. This is your homework for today. Take a note of this. Take a screenshot. Let me know what is the answer in the comment section below. I would be looking forward for that. The question is this. If the power of the lens is negative, then the lens is dash lens. Let me know what is the answer in the comment section below. I'd be looking forward for that. And also, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe, people. And also, one more important thing, you also have a scholarships test that is coming up, guys. The master's scholarship admission test, where you have 100 crore scholarship available for you people. And if you make it through that, you'll be getting the entire year's course for 100% free of cost. What you have to do is take a part in the test that happens every Sunday at 3 p.m. And it's from 25th of October till 29th of November. So the day, it's still going on every Sunday, 3 p.m. Take a part in the scholarship test. And if you are lucky enough, and if you do it right, you would also be getting a scholarship as well. And it's from grade 6 to 13. 13 is nothing but the repeater's badge. If you have taken a break from your, to give your JEE and all that, you can also take a part in that as well. And these are all the results that we've achieved in the last. Trust me, guys, you are in safe hands. These are all the, results that we got from online classes, from Vedantu itself. About 548 ranks across India. Again, it's one of the most toughest exams in the world in JEE Advanced. We got more than 500 ranks, close to 550 ranks, and 268 among that were in the top 10K, which is very, very hard to do. And one of the three students who enrolled Vedantu actually got a good rank as well. 27 students in NEET and 46 students scored more than 550 marks, and 27 about 600 as well, which is very hard to do again. And in 10th and 12th, about 171 students got 90% above in 10th, and 157 students got 90% above in 12th grade as well. So these are some of the names. Maybe soon, one day, you could have your photos also put up over here. That is it from my side, guys. Do not forget to take a part in the quiz. And also, the link is given in the description below for you to avail the prize, which will be 50% off till 15th of November again. Do not forget to like, share, subscribe. Let me know whatever doubts you have right now. That's okay. That's it from my side. Let me know if you have any doubts, guys. Sir, mujhe pata nahi chala kab session shuru ho gaya. It's all right, Mr. AJ. It's okay. It happens. So what is your brand of mobile phone? I have a OnePlus 8. I got a OnePlus 8 very recently. Until then, I was using Xiaomi. And I don't know if you guys have heard about Poco phone. So I had a Poco and then I bought this one. Yeah. 39th, it's all right, Arun. Very chilled. As long as you got all the questions right, that's all that matters. Thank you, K2G. Thanks a lot. Menti's over. Yeah, sad, no, Barbie. Sad. Tears are all rolling down your ears. It's okay. Yeah, Kito, short. I'll be there in the next one. Tomorrow again, we'll be meeting, guys. Tomorrow again, we have, we have another session tomorrow, which will again be a quiz. Just Menti, nothing else, for the entire chapter of refraction through lenses. So I hope to see you guys over there. Yeah, exactly at 5:45. I'll be here. I want you guys also to be there. Let's see who wins it. Next time is going to be #P. Let's see. Oh my god! iPhone 13. Okay, I believe you. What are you from the future, huh? How to edit Menti? Sashi, all you have to do is this, duh. Go to www.menti.com, menti.com. So if you go to that website, they'll ask you for a code, the code for today. So I'll give the code for every session. It's a different code. So I'll give the code, just enter that code and you'll be a part of the course. That's all, right? CBSE session kab hoga? It'll be soon. We are still working on light wala chapter. We are still doing that. We still have many more sessions to go. So after that is done, we'll have the mentee as well for that. Right? Don't worry. Yeah. Sure, Devbita, I'm really very sorry for not replying to your email. I'll definitely check it up. I'm really sorry. I've been packed these days. I'll definitely check it up. Right? Hi, Parmeshwar. Welcome. 15th. Aray, Bharaviji, congratulations. So who's the winner for mentee today? Siddhant. it's P. #P. Anyways, so why tell OS Varda? Okay, why am I so lucky, da princess? Why am I lucky? So when will the exam be? It'll be if you talk about the scholarship exams, it'll be on every Sunday at 3 PM. Da, every Sunday at 3 PM. All right. Kabir, tomorrow we'll have another mentee. Da. Tomorrow we'll be having the entire the full chapter mentee, that is refraction through lenses, the whole chapter mentee. All right. Yeah. It is urgent. Oh, sure, Dev, but I'll definitely check it up today. 100% I'll reply to your email. All right. Happy birthday. Whose birthday? It's not my birthday. Long back, Kabir. I'm sorry, da. Sorry. What is hashtag? Hashtag is like an hashtag. You know, hashtag is like, it looks like hashtag. Looks like this, something like that. Anyways, thank you, da. Thank you. CPNC. Thank you, Bhargaviji. Thank you. It's all right, Arey Vigdanji. It's all right. No worries. You did good, buddy. That's all. Chhota Menti, yes, da, we did. As long as we have live sessions, we'll have Menti. If I'm coming live, then for sure we'll have Menti. And from now on, every week, 3 days in a week, I'll be coming live, guys. So 3 days in a week, that is every Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, I'll be coming live from now on. So every Thursday, Wednesday, and Friday, we will be having Menti for sure. Cross my heart, hope to die, touch wood, we'll definitely have Menti. Pakkar! So PM Modi is my friend because when the Mann Ki Baat program started, I got notified through PM Modi. Yeah, he's your best friend. No, yes, I've seen. Thank you, Kiran. Thanks a lot. Yeah, by the way, happy Diwali in advance. Thank you. Thanks a lot, guys. Stay safe. Exactly. Stay safe. Stay healthy, people. Thank you for joining. I hope to see you guys tomorrow. Until the next time we meet, this is Anu signing off for the day. Bye bye. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. How many likes did we get so far? 7.